Hey guys, it's Melanie. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make a super, super easy headband. This headband right here, I made this from a scrap of fabric from my casserole carrier video. I have an adult size and a kid's size. Really easy. There's a little bit of elastic in the back, so it's nice and comfortable to wear. I like this little bit, you know, more narrow size headband. I think it's going to be a really fun project. Super easy, beginner friendly. So let's get going. I'm going to show you how to make it.
We need our piece of fabric, which is 3¾ by 19 for the adult size. We need some pins, coordinating thread, and a 4-inch piece of elastic. Take your piece of fabric, fold it right sides together lengthwise, and we're going to take it over to the machine and sew it 1/4 inch down that long side. For the adult, you can use about a 19-inch piece, and kids, you can use 18-inch, babies smaller than that. If you are unsure, you can always measure the head and make sure that it's gonna fit properly, but the elastic does make sure that there is a little bit of give there. Now we are going to turn our piece of fabric right side out. You can see right here, it's not too small of a piece. This should not be very difficult, but it does take a moment to do. So turn that right side out and then take it over to your ironing board and we are going to iron it down. You can use that seam and roll it in between your fingers to kind of make sure that it's evenly pressed and nice and neat looking. Now you're going to take the ends and using your fingers, place about 1/2 inch worth of fabric on the inside and then we are going to press it and that's where our elastic is going to go. So about 1/2 inch in there, just make sure it's nice and neat, place your elastic inside the opening and about 1/2 inch down and then we're going to pin it in place. Now do the same thing with the other side and then we're going to insert the elastic on the other side as well. Pressing is going to be your best friend with this, so just make sure that's nice and neat and that it will all lay nice and properly when you go to sew it. Use your pins, make sure they're nice and secure, take that over to the sewing machine, and I'm just going to use the width of my presser foot and sew down, backstitching well, down the side of this headband here. Now you can backstitch over that elastic if you want to. I'm actually going to do that here. You can see me, I'm going to go backstitch just to give a little bit of an extra reinforcement to that elastic. Backstitch again at the end. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do another little stitch, especially if kids are going to be wearing this. I want it to be nice and secure. So I'm going to do another round of stitching right here. You can use coordinating thread for this one. You will see the thread, but it is going to be, of course, on the back of the head, you know, by the nape of the neck. Do this again on the other side. And now if you would like to be done, you can be done. The headband looks great just like this. But if you wanted to add a little bit of top stitching, I'm going to show you how to do that right here. Again, using the width of the presser foot, just about 1/4 inch or a scant 1/4 inch, I would say, from this side of the headband, we are gonna just place a little top stitch. This is where you can get fun and creative with the thread choice, the color choice, or you can just do something that blends in. It adds a little bit of a finishing touch, but totally optional. You do not have to do this. The headband will look beautiful without it. So I did wanna show you some options with this feature and see, you know, what you guys thought. Of course, measurements and materials listed, everything that I use for this video will be listed in the description box below the video. So you can check there if you have any questions. The written description will be down there as well. Trim your threads. And you can see here the pink one. I did not do the top stitching, so you can kind of see the difference in the look. Both very functional. I hope you enjoy this project.
All right, guys, thanks so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up and share this video with anyone you think you might enjoy it. That's a great way to support this channel. Also, any links for things that I mentioned or products that I use will be down in the description box. I will have all of that filled out with all the information for you. The written instructions will be there as well with all the measurements. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.